to this day. To this day.
Rich people don't sleep 8 hours a day.
That's stupid. Use your common sense.
This is Off the Top. I am Bushido Spirit. Here I have Philly. Say something, Philly.
What's up?
All right, we got Mo here.
Hello.
All right, so let's get right into the shit, man. So Disney's movie, Lion King, the live action version, is coming out on the 19th, I think, next week. And Donald Glover went on Jimmy Kimmel's show to talk about the film and his experiences with Beyonce, right? And in that interview, they showed a clip from the movie, and it was one of the songs, Hakuna Matata. And it wasn't what we expected. So let's go ahead and watch that. We'll give our take on it.
Today is Halloween.
They'll be like, maybe this candy isn't so crazy.
That's good. All right, I like that. I'm going to employ that in my own personal life.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
It's a problem-free philosophy.
Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata.
It means no worries.
It's a problem-free philosophy.
Hakuna Matata.
That is the Lion King.
Okay, I need to look.
Okay. All right. Give me a second. You know when a movie does a cross promotion with like an energy drink or like a branded product?
Yeah.
And you got like the slightly less like lower quality CGI for the commercial. You know what I mean? Like that one Ant-Man and like Hulk Coca-Cola commercial. This is the Lion King Pepsi commercial. That's what that should look like to me. Like the
can we cuss?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. Can we cuss? This is garbage, man. Like, wait.
Garbage is your cuss word?
No, I just wanted to clarify that before, like, so I could really express myself later on. Don't worry, it's gonna come out. But it's just like, what the heck is, like, what's going on? Like, there's so many things that are wrong with this. Timon is so small. Like, in the whole, there's so much space between Simba and Pumbaa that in order to pan out enough to see both of them, you can barely see Timon. The background, while I guess true to a jungle setting, isn't vibrant at all. It's like dead. You know what I mean? Everything looks fucking muted in this. Like, what the heck? Like, this ain't even... The movements it's like they're trying to be photorealistic, but like it doesn't transfer well.
It doesn't.
The wildest part is they got it right once. Like they did a pretty damn good job with Jungle Book, from what I remember.
They got it right now. They got it right. They got it too right. Is what's fucked. Like, this is how a lion, if an actual lion had a voice and could sing. This is how, and dance, or if you want to call whatever Simba does in this dancing, that is exactly how they would move and dance. They've achieved photorealism through CG, and it's shit.
It doesn't, like you said, it don't have the flavor or the style, man. The pizzazz, it's flat.
Like I wouldn't a soda even, that been sitting out in something the, as in abstract the sun. As that. I don't think it's anything nearly as abstract as that. Yeah. What I think is I said this shit like 100 times already, but I'm going to say it 101 times by the end of this shit. So my thing is like, this is always going to be second place to animation. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, the heart and soul of what these characters are doing on screen is in the animation. And as soon as you take that away and you replace it with something that's supposed to be more realistic, you're essentially robbing the thing of its soul. Like, that shit is dead.
I don't know. Would you say the same for something like Toy Story?
What do you mean?
Like, you when you say this will always be secondhand animation, do you mean this specific movie or do you mean CG in general?
Oh, no, but, like, the thing with Toy Story is that 3D animation can have all the soul in the world. Like, I'm the dude that dick rides, like, Into the Spider-Verse, and that's a 3D animated movie.
But that's heavily stylized based off 2D animation.
True, but generally the 3D models are still 3D. You know what I mean? They're made to look like they're cel-shaded in the way that a comic book would look, but at the same time, it's still a 3D like model. You know what I mean? But this, yeah, but the stylization definitely helps with it because that's still animation in my head. This is attempting for photorealism, and the issue with that is that you're limiting your characters to the range of motion of just that specific animal, which is never going to compare to animation. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, once you
seek to follow the rules of the real world, you're left falling under the limitations of the real world, which means like you're never going to get to that point. You're never going to get to that point.
Yeah, and you talking about Timon? Yeah, that it's Puma, the fat one. I mean it's just realistic for it to be smaller. So that's why
right,
they did. Yeah.
Right, but I'm like, but they could have done things with the camera angle. At one point, they have him run to the foreground, along a rock or something. So they do a little bit to kind of give him his space or whatever, but. For the most, and what scares me the most is this is the one they decided to bring on Jimmy Kimmel. This was the one, like, people gonna love this. Yeah, let me put this one out, you know what I mean? They're gonna eat this up. And it's doo-doo. So if this is doo-doo, like...
I don't know, because the trailer looked way better, though. So maybe this is not...
Yeah.
Maybe this is...
Straight up. Yeah. It's unfinished. Like, this is not... This is straight up just not... Like, it's not even about it not being to the quality we expect. It's not even to the quality of the trailer itself. Like, the trailer look squeaky clean. That should look shiny. You know what I mean? That should look like it was ready to be served today. This doesn't look that way. You know what I mean?
But then again, that's like quick clips, and this is like a full scene.
A solid, yeah.
So maybe that's the thing.
And I also feel like this what's irritating me about the reboots is they use the same song. And I'm like, if I understand it's a reboot, but if you know you can't do the same things with the or similar, give the same kind of vibe that you had with that you did with the original, just do something different. Go in a different route. You know what I mean? Introduce characters that maybe weren't in the original.
They're afraid of that.
Come up with some original songs that didn't exist
Somebody that would even consider doing something as daring as that would never make a Lion King reboot to begin with, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, and you see how mad people got when they changed the color Ariel. I mean, that's slightly different, I'm guessing. But it's people don't like change, man. So if you were to take some of the songs out and put some new ones in, they would just hate on it automatically without giving it a chance.
Ultimately, then the point of a reboot is it's pointless. I don't...
Yeah.
Literally. I feel like you put Lion King on something and you do something different that people can get behind, and I think you can sell tickets. I don't think they'll necessarily get mad. Like, I mean, we're doing a Little Mermaid reboot with a black girl. You mean to tell me, like, come on, where do you draw the line as far as taking a creative license with the property that's yours? You can make a new song. You can you know what I mean? I just make songs maybe that are inspired some of the old ones.
Yo, I heard I think Donald Glover talked about it in an interview. Like, I heard that they were doing some new songs, but I mean, judging by what I've seen so far, I haven't seen any new songs, but
you're not gonna put the new song as your first foot forward, you know what I mean? You sell tickets by giving them what they know.
You're right.
Well, if they can do some new songs there, then, you know, I'm happy about it. So at least, because from what I'm seeing as a CG adaptation, it's trash. So if you were going to do something like this, go your own route. You know what I mean? Yeah. Make your own type of story image that makes sense given this style. But don't just rehash it like that.
I will say this though, like, let's be fair for even a second, right? This actual sequence, the whole that part where like they come out of the bushes and he's fully grown and he starts singing, that's like the latter half, if not the final part of that song. Like, we missed the entire like crossing the massive log bridge like sequence where he's growing up. We missed the beginning where he tries to eat the bugs for the first time. Like, we miss a whole bunch of
shit. This is the part that gives me chills, though, in the original song, where he's fully, like, he walks across the bridge.
Oh, my God. That shit, that shit pissed my heart when I, like, listen. The part where, like, he has so much swag. He had all the swag on the planet. And he's like,
and he belts that note out.
And he's like, enemies, no. That shit, I was like, oh, no.
No, but I'm saying, like, when he first, because when he drops that note that he does in his trailer, you see the full adult Simba.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? For the first time.
Why would I just realized something. Why would you share this ever, like, before the movie? Like, this is the first time we hear Donald Glover's voice in the movie. Think about that. It's the first time we hear it.
He belts that note out too, like in the original, and he does the same. He does it justice. I really don't think I was gonna call him Childish Gambino. I really don't think Donald Glover can sing, but he does this song justice.
Good, but good job.
He's good at harmonizing. The whole thing is,
in this one, when he drops that note, he just walks out of the CG fucking forest. You know what I mean? He walks out of the CG jungle, and I don't feel shit.